What's up guys, Sal here. So last month Samsung showcased a sound emitting display concept which will result in an elimination of an earpiece, helping extend the screen all the way from top to bottom.
What we're trying to do is get rid of this receiver hole that you speak with,
yeah.
And instead we have a sound vibration coming from right here that vibrates the whole screen. So now the sound when you talk to someone on the phone is coming from the whole screen.
As you saw, a Samsung representative was explaining the sound on display tech running in what seems to be a Galaxy S9 Plus. She explains how a panel using vibration and bone conduction may negate the need for an earpiece. She also says that the quality of the speaker will be as good as the normal speaker.
Well, it's very clear. It's very loud also.
And now by getting rid of the hole, we can extend the screen all the way from top to bottom for a full edge-to-edge screen.
And then the reporter asks her this.
Nice, so I know exactly what the Galaxy S10 is going to be now.
Yes.
It's going to be 100%, right?
Yes, 100%. No, but it is.
It could be.
I think that's what they're going for. Yes.
She might have said that casually, but today's report coming right out of South Korea sheds more light on this. Korean media today tips that this prototype won't stay such for long. The publication states that Samsung is ready to commercialize this sound-on-display tech in their flagship phones next year. And the source even goes on to peg the exact size of Samsung's screen in question, 6.2 inches, which is the rumored screen size for the Galaxy S10. Assuming that this rumor is true, does this mean that Samsung is going for an all-screen design with the Galaxy S10? I mean, the only reason companies put this technology on their phones is to eliminate the bezels. Xiaomi did this with the Mi Mix, Vivo just launched Vivo Next with no top bezel using this technology. Yeah, there's still a front camera to be worried about, but Samsung can use their holes on display patent technology where they can put holes on the display for the camera. I still think the full screen is not gonna happen. I mean, it will happen someday, but the odds of that happening with the Galaxy S10 are very, very low. But hey, never say never, right? You never know what's gonna happen next, just like in life, so yeah, fingers crossed for that. Anyway, let me know your thoughts on this in the comments below, and as always, I'll see y'all tomorrow. Peace out.